It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler.
He's your only black friend, so he's your best black friend. I wouldn't trade him for another black friend.
Because black friends are rare, as you should be aware.
He smiles like Richard Pryor, so just sit and stare.
It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler. It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler. It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler.
Hello, everybody. This is Tyler Preston 20. I'm here with a special guest. His name is Jonathan Bellis. He is a filmmaker from Spain behind a new movie called The Dawn of Kaiju Ega. And basically, this whole entire movie is about the origin of Godzilla. And I'm here with him today to talk about the production behind the movie and also some various aspects about the filming process. Hello, how are you?
Hello, Tyler. I'm fine, thank you. Really honored of this interview.
Yes, it's also an honor to also talk to you about your movie. Now, before we talk about the movie, I want to know, like, what's your first experience with the Godzilla franchise? Like, how old were you when you first bought The King of the Monsters?
Well, everything started many years ago. I think it was like when I was 8 years old. I remember perfectly this moment. I was with my mom and her best friend, and she directly talked to me about Godzilla, something I didn't hear about that and at this time. And I didn't know what was that or how was that. The only thing I knew at this time was what this friend told me. And she told me it was very huge and he always destroys Tokyo. So I was really interested in this because at this time I was very fascinated by for movies about monsters or dinosaurs, etc. And for many years, this person gave me a lot of tapes of Godzilla movies recorded from the TV. And that's how I discovered Godzilla, thanks to her. And the first Godzilla movie I saw was the 1992 version of Godzilla versus Mothra. And by the way, in the beginning of this documentary, there is a memorial logo about her.
It's really interesting that your mom introduced you to the franchise. Do you think because of the franchise that inspired you to become a filmmaker? Like, how long have you been studying filmmaking?
Yeah, absolutely. Since the beginning, I really enjoyed watching wildlife and natural documentaries and dinosaur movies, by the way, such as 1 Million Years BC or The Valley of Wangi. And however, the day I discovered Godzilla, everything changed in my life. I was not the same since then. And I was born with, I always say I was born with a pencil and a camera. So I painted hundreds of times the Japanese monsters and I shot a lot of movies with my own Godzilla models. And once I did a 2 meters model of Tokyo, including the Tokyo Tower, of course. And Godzilla movies were done, as we know, Godzilla movies were done with physical special effects and not CGI. So I felt like I could do that with my own hands. So it was a really funny time and very creative experience for me. My fascination with the special effects inspired me to becoming a filmmaker, for sure. And regarding my studies, I have studied 11 years. My degree in fine arts were 5. My master's in art was 1 more year and 5 more years for my PhD. And by the way, I just would like to say that my PhD is about Kaiju Ega.
That is really, really interesting that you used to make movies with like the action figures at home. That's really funny. As far as prior to this documentary, did you make any other movies besides the ones at home? Like, did you do any other major film productions before your documentary?
Sure, Tyler. Actually, The Dawn of Kaiju Ega is my third documentary film. And before this documentary, I did many videos. And speaking about documentaries, this is the third, as I said. And the two first documentaries were, the first one was about the painter, René Magritte, who was a painter the last century, based in Brussels. And I did this documentary when I was 19, in 2009 and 2010, approximately. And my second documentary film was produced during the production of this documentary about Godzilla in 2016. And this is a documentary film about the Spanish comedy, especially in the theaters and films. And furthermore, I did a lot of short films, fiction films, and also advertisements for clients I had in the last 10 years. Yeah, I founded my own company in 2012. The name is 451 Productions, and this is the name comes from the movie, the French movie Fahrenheit 451. And I'm sure you know the movie or the author of the book in the 50s. And this movie was really hit in my life also, as Godzilla was, and that's why I still keep this like this memorial in my the name of the company. And you can find a lot of information in my website, is 451prod.com, and there is more material, not only documentaries, not only entertainment, but also dance videos or art videos.
So how did you come up with the idea for your documentary? Was it really easy to think about the topics that you wanted to cover? Which for this case, Godzilla is about, of course, the inspirations behind the movies. And so was it really easy to come up with the idea for your documentary?
Well, let me think about this. It's, when I was still studying fine arts in 2009, I already thought about this documentary, and especially the research about Kaiju Ega and the future PhD. When I get role in my PhD, it was in 2012, is when I really thought about or planned how to do this project. And my idea was clear. My idea was basically collect all the interviews I could and tell the background of Godzilla, the symbolism of Godzilla. And this was my goal, basically. Because in here in Europe, obviously movies get old easier. So especially movies with special effects, tokusatsu movies as the Japanese, no? The people, new generation, are not too much ready to see these movies and appreciate maybe all the work they had behind of the camera.
Earlier, you mentioned the word Kaiju Eiga. Now, for those who are not familiar with like this terminology, and you also said tokusatsu, like what does these words mean for those who are listening to us but have no idea what the meaning behind these words?
Well, I believe that if you are not familiar with Japanese culture, probably you can't understand what Kaiju Ega means. I mean, the word itself, no? We know Kaiju means monster and Ega film in Japanese. And the fusion of them create this subgenre of films. So for the words, I think it's difficult for general audiences to know what it means. However, if you saw Kaijus, that's Godzilla, for example, everybody's going to recognize the monster because it's really, really popular, not only in Japan, but in the world, as we can imagine. And I think since Guillermo del Toro produced and directed the movie Pacific Rim, maybe audiences know now what Kaiju means, because it's a word really used in the movie. We see that in the first frame of the movie, the meaning of Kaiju. I think this is very interesting, and we have to thank him for this.
Getting back to the documentary, was it really hard to find the filmmakers and actors behind these Godzilla movies to make your documentary? And how many days, months did it take for your shooting schedule?
First of all, I have to say I don't speak Japanese at all. Now maybe I understand a little more, but back in that time, in 2012-13, I didn't speak at all any word. And my English was really, really poor, I have to say. However, I was really sure about my goals. So I did everything in order to get appointments as much as I could with all the Japanese filmmakers and actors from Kaiju Ega movies in Japan. And this step only took more than 1 year and a half, only that. Only gathering all the people, collect them, I mean, for say to them, okay, next year, 2014, actually, February, I go to Japan, so please let's prepare this, let's set up this interview. And by the way, for to meet all these people, such as actors Akira Takarada or Aruna Kajima, was a dream come true. I didn't realize how lucky I was because some of the cast of the film, of this film, passed away recently. Fortunately, I could play the Don of Kaiju Ega with Akira Takarada, Susuke Kaneko, among others, in the premiere of the film in Tokyo last April 2019. And yeah, I have to say also, the Don of Kaiju Ega was shot independently. I didn't get any sponsor or partnership, and but I try. I try to get partnership with, for example, for my former university, TV stations, etc. But now, nobody was really interested in co-produce a film, a documentary film about Godzilla, and that was very sad and very hard for me. So I thought, in order to get the money and the resources as a crazy Godzilla fan, I have to say I went to Japan with 8 appointments with Japanese filmmakers, but I back to Europe with more than 20 interviews recorded. So I couldn't believe it. And of course it couldn't happen with the support of Spanish writer and interpreter Daniel Aguilar, who assisted me in Japan. And he did all the translations from Japanese to Spanish. And I don't know, I remember I have in my hard disk like 35 hours of interviews of all these people. I cut all that until 51 minutes, that is the runtime of the film, of Dawn of Kaiju Ega. And the editing was really hard because of that. Regarding the schedule, I have to say it was a long adventure. The whole production took around 8 years. I did the first interviews to Spanish film experts in 2012, and I continued in Japan in 2014. Afterwards, I did some more interviews in Spain. The last one was in 2018. I started the editing in 2017, but I didn't finish it until beginning 2018. However, I did some changes in the editing till the end of December 2018. So it was like 7-8 years of production. And I have to confess, I did until 14 different versions of the film. And it's crazy. It's just I did version of 1 hour, or there's 40 minutes, or the 45 until the final version, the final product, that it was the 51 minutes. And please let me thank to all these people that worked hard in this production. My brother Ruben Bellés, my friend Octavio López, and the film editor José Luis Romeo, who supervised the final cut of the film. And finally, to Ségolène Lacour, also, that she got involved in the project in 2018, but since then she worked as a crazy in the narrative aspect of the film.
Honestly, I cannot imagine just being in a room with the original creators of the Godzilla movies. I'm not sure if I could actually compose myself, like, I would probably, you know, be excited to see them and talk to them. It's interesting that, of course, you mentioned earlier that, of course, Godzilla is really famous worldwide outside of Japan. Of course, we know that in my country, it's really popular with conventions like G-Fest. I'm kind of curious, like, is the fandom for Godzilla really huge in Spain? Are these movies really, like, easy to find on DVD, or you have to import movies outside your country?
Well, we can't really compare Spain with all the fandom, Godzilla fandom of Japan, for example, or the US, no? It's a very big country. And, of course, we have our own film festivals about fantasy or science fiction movies, but also some events about that, but especially about the Japanese pop culture. So that includes anime, for example, and other filmmakers, not only about Godzilla, obviously. So I would say it is not huge. Of course, there are a lot of events, as I said, but not about Godzilla itself. That way, as I mentioned before, my friend Octavio and I, for example, and Robert Ortiz, we have created what year was that, 2003, yeah, a website called GodzillaEnCastellano.com, and that is where we gathered, I think, the Godzilla fandom community, you know, in Spain. Sometimes also in from South America, but especially from Spain. And I have to say, it's not so big. But there are a lot of Godzilla fans in general, no. Regarding the DVDs or the movies release of Godzilla in Spain, yeah, we had a lot, some of the titles on DVD in the beginning of this century, in the 2001 and 2007, we had some hazy Godzilla movies or some of the Showa movies, not at all, a few of them, and yeah, but. The last years, some companies get released in Blu-ray some Godzilla movies, but some of them are not legal. I mean, they're illegal copies, obviously. So I don't buy them, basically. And what I do is I buy my Godzilla Blu-rays or DVDs from the US, for example, which we can find the amazing Criterion pack of. Godzilla, which is it's amazing. So I think that is enough. If you speak English or you understand a little, you can follow the movies because you know the movies by heart from you are a kid, no? So I think it's enough. Yeah, something interesting I would like to add is about the Emmerich Godzilla movie. This movie was very very popular in Spain, and actually a lot of Spanish people believe that this is the last Godzilla movie still. Fortunately, we have the latest American version, so now they know this is the last movie. But they don't know too much about the Japanese Millennium Saga, for example, or Shin Godzilla, which I think is a very great movie. So, well, step by step, we have a lot of work to do.
I guess my final questions for you before we wrap up the interview would be like, what are your favorite Godzilla movies? And what are your least favorite Godzilla movies? Because the franchise has been going on for like 60 plus years. And each fan has their own favorite movies and their not favorite movies. So what are your favorite ones and your not favorite ones?
They are really very difficult questions for me, even for say my favorite or the one I like less. It's very difficult because all the Godzilla movies are very special for me, even the worst. But regarding my favorite, I can say the first one. It's the first Godzilla movie from 1954. I think it's still the best Godzilla movie, and I think it's because Ishiro Honda was clear with the goal of the movie, which was be respectful with all the background about the atomic bomb, and it's just amazing how he depicts this atmosphere of the war, the post-war, the nuclear threat in his movies, especially in Godzilla, the first Godzilla. Yeah, this. Images we have about the after the Godzilla destruction, they are even more interesting than the destruction itself. No? When we see all the people in the hospitals that is just affected by the radiation of Godzilla, it's like just like the victims of Hiroshima and Nagasaki bombs. And I think it's almost like a documentary in some ways, no? Because you compare the original footage of 1945 and the movie, and it's quite similar. It's just crazy and very very interesting, and also this black and white photography of the movie. I think is that the two aspects are the best in my opinion. And of course, the second option, my second favorite film of Godzilla is Shin Godzilla. As I said previously, for me it's incredible movie. It's new, it's fresh, it's putting a lot of new elements in the saga. And it's just amazing because it's like we take the best of the first Godzilla, the best of the Return of Godzilla, the movie from 1984, and we create Shin Godzilla. Plus the ideas, the crazy ideas of Hideaki Anno, no? the filmmaker. I think it's the best movie of Godzilla made in the last 20 years. And finally, I think my third option is Godzilla vs. The Thing. because I really like this movie. All this music, the shots with the explosions, the bombs, the bombing of Godzilla, it's just incredible. And the worst, my least favorite one, it's difficult, as I said from the beginning, because all of them have something special to me. But if I have to choose, I'm going to say the movies, all the movies from the 70s, I think, yeah. Even I have a very, I'm really in love with Gigan. I really like this monster. So this chicken, psychedelic chicken from the space.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, that's of course the filmmaker Jonathan Bellis. He is of course the director of The Dawn of Kaiju Eiga, the latest documentary for Godzilla. And of course, by the time this interview comes up, I'll provide a link to the description to see the whole entire documentary. And of course, earlier you mentioned that you help with like Godzilla and Casiano. Is there any other sites like or like social media that people can follow you? And if so, what are your social media accounts?
Sure. You can find me on Facebook and Instagram with my name, Jonathan Bellis. And also you can find my professional social media accounts on Facebook and Instagram too. The name is 451Prods. But also you can find me, or you can find more details about the documentary Dawn of Kaiju Eiga on Facebook. The name is Dawn of Kaiju Eiga, or the official website, dawnofkaijueiga.com.
And of course, anybody listening to this podcast, my social media accounts are on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and YouTube at TylerPreston20. Okay, thanks so much for being part of the interview. I really appreciate it. Muchas gracias por contestar mi preguntas, amigo.
Thanks to you, Tyler. I really enjoyed the interview. I hope you enjoyed too my answers. And muchas gracias a ti también, Tyler. Un abrazo.
It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler. He's your only black friend, so he's your best black friend. I wouldn't trade him for another black friend. Because black friends are rare, as you should be aware. He smiles like Richard Pryor, so just sit and stare. It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler. It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler. It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler.